In this tutorial, we'll create a simple Jakarta EE web application that displays a Hello World message in our browser. We'll be using IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate to take advantage of the enterprise features available to us. We can create a new project from the welcome page by clicking on the New Project button. We want to create a Java Enterprise project, so we will select Java Enterprise on the left column. Next, we want to select the JDK for compiling this project. If you have an existing configured JDK in IntelliJ IDEA, it will be listed in the top of the JDK list. Or you can use the Download JDK option. I will use this option to download Java 8 since it's currently the highest Java version that is compatible with Jakarta EE. From the drop-down menu, I will select Java 8 as my Java version, which will give me a list of vendors to choose from. You can select any of the vendors. For this tutorial, I will select Adopt OpenJDK with Hotspot, then click Download. I will use the IntelliJ IDEA web application template, which will provide me with some basic template files for my application. Next, I need to configure an application server for my Jakarta EE application. If you already have an application server set up, you can configure it at this point. Click New and choose your application server from the list. In this tutorial, I will be using Classfish, so I'll be selecting Classfish from this list. Since I don't currently have Classfish set up, I will go quickly download Classfish and configure it as my application server. I'll go to the Downloads page for Classfish and select the latest Classfish 6 release available to me. After the download is complete, I will extract and move the Classfish install to my App Servers folder. Let's verify that everything is extracted as expected, and now we can copy the path to the Classfish install and go back to IntelliJ IDEA to paste in our copied path as our Classfish home. Then we click OK. Now that my application server is configured, I can choose my build tool. For this tutorial, I will use Maven, and for testing, I will use JUnit. We're only using Java in our application, so I will leave the rest of the languages unchecked. Then click Next. In the next window, I will select Jakarta EE 9 from the drop-down menu. In the next section, we see a list of all the libraries and frameworks we could use in our enterprise application. We can see that the servlet framework is already checked since I'm using the web application template, so I will go ahead and click Next. We'll give our project a name. In my case, I'll call it Jakarta EE Hello World. I can change the location for my project. In this case, I'll just accept the default. For my artifact coordinates, I will enter my company name, then accept the defaults for the rest. We can now click Finish and IntelliJ IDEA will create our web project. Let's take a look at what IntelliJ IDEA created for us. We see a Hello Server class with a doGet method that displays a Hello World message when it's called. Now let's take a look at the index file created by IntelliJ IDEA. I will search for it by double-clicking Shift and searching for index. Looks like there is an index.jsp file in this web project. This is the file that the user will see by default when they navigate to our web application in the browser. Looks like this JSP file will display a Hello World message, then a link that will call our Hello servlet. Well, let's run this application and see it in action. First, we need to finish configuring our server run configuration. So we'll go to the drop-down menu at the top and click Edit Configuration. In this window, most of the fields are already pre-configured. And notice that by default, IntelliJ IDEA will launch my default web browser after the server starts and my application is deployed, then go to the URL at the root of my web application. I will change my configuration a bit and tell IntelliJ IDEA to update my application's classes and resources whenever I move away from my IDE. With this setting, when I switch from IntelliJ IDEA to my browser, the application files will automatically be updated. We also need to specify a server domain. By default, Glassfish creates a domain one, so we'll use that, then click OK. Now we're ready to start our server and run our application. To run our server, we can either click on the Run button or use the shortcut by pressing Shift F10 for Windows and Linux or Control R for macOS. You'll see the Services 2 window come up, showing that our Classfish server is running with our Jakarta EE Hello World War deployed to the server. In the output, we see the server starting and the application being deployed. Once the application is deployed, IntelliJ IDEA will open my default browser and go to my application's URL. We see the content of our index.jsp file being displayed and our Hello World message being printed here. We also see the link to the Hello servlet, and when we click it, we see the servlet's Hello World message. Great! Now that we have successfully run our web application, let's make some changes to it. On the homepage, I want to change this Hello servlet link to something else. Let's go back to IntelliJ IDEA and go to our index.jsp file. I'll go to my link text and change it to Click Me and then Save. Since I already configured my server run configurations to automatically update my application's resources when I leave IntelliJ IDEA, I can simply go back to my browser and refresh to see my changes. We now see the updated link text show up in our browser. Notice that we did not have to restart the server to see our changes. From here, we can make any changes we want to our Jakarta EE application. We can use the Services tool window to restart, debug, or stop the server. In this tutorial, we created a new Jakarta EE Hello World application and successfully ran it on our application server. Thanks for watching.